Hello dear students, welcome back. Friends, we are recording about the branches of the external carotid artery. So the first branch, that was the superior thyroid artery. We recorded about that artery and its branches and its which parts of the body does that artery supply. Now in this lecture we are recording about the next branch from the external carotid artery, that is the lingual artery. Right, let's see lingual artery. Okay friends, about this artery I have also recorded in the blood supply of the tongue in the section of the human digestive system. You can go and watch those lectures also regarding the human digestive system, but this is a separate lecture on the separate arteries of the body. So this one should be cleared here, that lingual artery is a branch of, let me write here, it is a branch of external carotid artery, right? What is its origin point, from where does it arises? It arises at the greater cornu of the hyoid bone. It arises at level of greater cornu of hyoid bone. Right friends, we will see in the diagram, don't worry. But in some exceptional cases friends, sometimes this artery arises combinedly with the fascial artery, right? Sometimes first we should know that this artery arises as a separate branch from the external carotid artery. The first thing is that, but in some cases this artery arises like this. Look, it is the external carotid artery, right? And external carotid artery gives off a common artery, and from this common artery there is the fascial artery and there is the lingual artery, right? Here the lingual artery is separately arising and the fascial artery is separately arising from the external carotid artery, but in some cases external carotid artery gives a common branch and from it the fascial artery and the lingual artery arises. So this artery is called the lingofacial trunk, right? It arises separately, but in some cases sometimes it combinedly arises with the fascial artery, which is called the lingofacial artery. Sometimes arises with, sometimes it combinedly arises with fascial artery, right? That's why we call it the lingofacial trunk. Right, so this part is called the lingofacial trunk. That's why, because from this trunk, facial artery and lingual artery both sometimes arises. Right, friends. Let's discuss about the branches of this lingual artery. What are its branches? Okay. So from lingual artery, the first artery which arises is the suprahyoid artery, right? The first branch suprahyoid artery. While we were discussing about the superior thyroid artery, there was infrahyoid artery, right? And below the hyoid bone, and this artery is arising and moving towards the superior surface of the hyoid bone. That's why we call it suprahyoid artery. Right, friends? Okay, let me draw here a diagram. For example, this is our hyoid bone, right? For example, this is our hyoid bone, and here is our external, this is our external carotid artery, and here was the superior thyroid artery, and from superior thyroid artery there was a branch, and this branch is called infrahyoid artery. And now here we have, friends, our lingual artery, right? So from lingual artery there is a branch, and this branch is called the suprahyoid artery. Very good. This should be clear now. Now this suprahyoid artery is responsible to supply blood to suprahyoid muscles. This was responsible to supply blood to infrahyoid muscles which were here, and this artery is responsible to supply blood to the suprahyoid muscles. It supplies suprahyoid muscles. It's so simple, right? And we are not concerned with those muscles right now, so we are just discussing the branches. So suprahyoid artery, then the next branch comes, and those are called the dorsal lingual arteries. Dorsal lingual arteries, right? Okay, this dorsal lingual artery supplying the let me write here as I'll show in this diagram all those arteries, don't worry, we will see which parts do they supply, right? So first of all, this dorsal lingual artery is responsible to supply the palatoglossus arch, palatoglossus arch, right? Dorsal lingual arteries. Then they are responsible to supply mucous membrane of the tongue, mucous membrane of tongue, right? Then the most important, they are responsible to supply the blood to the palatine tonsils, palatine tonsils, right? Palatine arteries, they are the branches of dorsal lingual artery. Then some parts of, then they are also responsible to supply blood to some parts of the palate, of palate, right, friends? So this was the supply of the dorsal lingual artery, what parts of the mouth parts of the mouth and glands they are supplying, right? The next artery which arises from this lingual artery is the sublingual artery. Sublingual artery. Friends, they are present on both sides, that's why we say sublingual arteries, but here we are mentioning just one artery, so sublingual artery. It is responsible to supply blood to the sublingual glands. I will show you in the diagram. Sublingual glands, right? Then they are also responsible to supply the blood to the mucous membrane which is present in the floor of mouth. Mucous membrane of floor of mouth, right? And they are also responsible to supply blood to gingiva or gums, right? So this is about the sublingual artery, the branch of the lingual artery. Then there is a branch which is called the fourth one and the last one, that is the deep lingual arteries. Deep lingual artery, right? We will see all of them in the diagram. Deep lingual artery is responsible to supply mostly the ventral aspects of the tongue, right? So mostly supply oxygenated blood to ventral aspects of the tongue. Ventral aspects of tongue. Clear, friends? Okay, this was about the lingual artery and its branches. Clear? So lingual artery is the second artery which we are discussing in the lectures on the branches of external carotid artery. The first one was suprahyoid artery, suprathyroid artery, and this is the lingual artery, and these are the branches of lingual artery: the suprahyoid artery, the dorsal lingual arteries, and the sublingual arteries, and the deep lingual artery. Now let's see all these arteries in this diagram so that we will clearly understand, right, friends? Now let me bring it here. Okay, let's name all these arteries. Clear, friends? Okay, as we know that our tongue has two types of muscles: the intrinsic muscles and the extrinsic muscles. Intrinsic muscles are those muscles which are present inside the tongue, right, which make the tongue, and extrinsic muscles are those muscles which are responsible to move the tongue, right? Okay, let's see here these arteries, friends. This is our external carotid artery, external carotid artery, right? This was the first branch which separated from it, and this was as you know the suprathyroid, superior thyroid artery. We are not concerned with that. We have discussed its branches in the previous lecture. Now look here, this branch which arises from the external carotid artery, this is the lingual artery, right? In this dark red color you can see all these branches. So this first branch which arises from it, as I have written here, is the suprahyoid artery, right? This is the suprahyoid artery. Clear, friends? Very good. Here is our hyoid bone, right? So this artery is the suprahyoid artery and is responsible to supply blood to the suprahyoid muscles. Very good. Then we move further forward and we see these two branches which are going towards the dorsal part of the tongue. That's why we call them dorsal lingual arteries. We have mentioned here dorsal lingual arteries, and they are responsible to supply the blood. Palatoglossus arch. Here is an arch which is called palatoglossus arch, and here we have our lingual palatine tonsils also we have on both sides. So these are the dorsal lingual arteries. Let me label them as dorsal lingual arteries. Right, these are the dorsal lingual arteries. I'm mentioning because it will be very easy for you guys to make the diagram clearly and to show all those arteries, right? So these are the dorsal lingual arteries, these two arteries on both sides, right? Then we move further forward. Further forward as we move, there is the sublingual artery, right? This artery is the sub means below the lingua, below the tongue, right? So this artery is the sublingual artery. Clear, friends? This is the sublingual artery, and you know that sublingual artery, I have written here, is responsible to supply blood to the sublingual gland. This is a sublingual gland. For example, I have just made one of them sublingual gland. Then there are mucous membranes in the floor of the mouth, and then there are gingiva or gums. So they are responsible. Look, these are the sublingual glandular arteries branches. Then you can also learn about them also. So sublingual artery is responsible to supply blood to the regions of the sublingual region, right? Then this artery, which is moving upward and into the tongue, to the anterior or ventral aspects of the tongue, that's why we call them deep lingual arteries. I have mentioned here deep lingual artery. So this one is the deep lingual artery, right, friends? Okay, Very good. These were the branches of the, this is the lingual artery, and these were its branches, and this is its diagram. You can see clearly that I have mentioned this is the lingual artery. Let me label it also. This is the lingual artery. Right, so lingual artery gives off the first branch, the suprahyoid artery, then it moves further and gives off two branches to the posterior or dorsal aspects of the tongue and the glands and the mucous membranes which are present here. So they are called the dorsal lingual arteries, and then we move forward, they make the sublingual artery, and then from this artery there is a branch which goes deep to the tongue to the interior aspects or ventral aspects. So that's why we call it the deep lingual artery. Friend, this was about the lingual artery. Now inshallah, in the next lecture we will record about the facial artery, which will be the third branch. I have my previous lecture here that I had told you that external carotid artery gives off 8 branches in 4 groups: anterior branches, posterior branches, medial branch and terminal branch. So in the anterior branch we have discussed about the superior thyroid artery and the lingual artery. Inshallah, in the next lecture we will discuss about the facial artery. Clear, friends? Thank you so much. If you like our lectures, please subscribe our channel. Thank you so much.